Hello, hello, hello.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Hey! Hey, what is this, some kind of sick prank? I get the greatest thing ever, just have it taken away? Why did you do this to me, God? Next time you're gonna get my hopes up, could you please take me to a grease monkey? Cause I like to get lubed up before I get huh? Some lube would be nice, or at least a courtesy lick, God. How about a little courtesy lick next time you decide to me?
Oh my God, I even have slow mode on, so the chat be moving. The chat be moving. You're wearing camo. I can hardly see you. Okay, cute, cute. I love this dress. I don't know what it is. It like does something for me. It's super cozy. Winning the crown over Feudy Beauty. Definitely not. Like, we have our own separate crown. She does her, I do me. Did you really walk home when Destiny left you at Walmart? Yes, I started to. And you left your partner at Walmart at 1 a.m. Like, it's so, like, red flag, red flag, red flag. And all while she's still talking to her ex behind my back. No wonder why she called me Pookie, because she was talking to Pookie behind my back. Krista said that would be an immediate breakup for me. Yeah, the whole situation is so... But yeah, I'm in the wrong. That's so funny. Why did she leave me at Walmart? Because, okay, so there was a, I'm pretty sure it was a Subway or a Burger King, I don't know. It was like inside of the Walmart, and she called me Pookie, and that really upset me because my gut and my intuition is always right. And I later found out that it's because she was still talking to her ex behind my back. She was re-downloading and downloading an app to talk to her ex behind my back. So anyways, she called me Pookie. I didn't want to be in her presence. So I actually went and sat down in the Subway, and I was just trying to calm down because it upset me. And she said she couldn't find me, but yet I was sitting right in front of the entrance. She is a joke. She is a lie. If someone left me for getting uncomfortable about saying something, you know, would get to me like that, I'd be so hurt. Oh, I was for sure hurt. And when I realized that she left, I ended up walking home, and I was about, I would say about halfway home, maybe a little further. And she ended up picking me up. I am not going to address a reaction channel. My therapy very much consisted of me talking about YouTube today, but I have been very bothered with people thinking that they have proof that I was not molested. That is disgusting. You go through trauma, especially when you disassociate or in the moment you have so much anxiety over situations that you lose certain memories and certain details. So when I say that my dad's friends sexually like assaulted me, I mean that in the sense of like sexually harassed me, and I have shared that several times. That is a completely different situation compared to when I was molested when I was a child. That is a completely different story. And people are confusing the two. Has Destiny reached out to me? Yes, she's freaking weird. I don't understand what her motive is, but like yesterday she sent me a picture of me and her mom on the beach. That's what she sent me. And I said, why are you sending me this? Don't really know what her motives are. And my favorite of it all is Dana even said like, she's totes fine with me talking about this. Destiny is literally messaging Dana behind her current fiance's back and denying it on live stream in front of her fiance. But yet Dana sent me screenshots, but I'm like, what is actually happening? Like, I don't know. Like, why didn't you go see a gyno for the bleeding? Actually, I went to doctors and I went to the ER a couple of times. I went every single time. I was told that it was just a UTI, but yet I showed a lot of signs of cancer. So as for not going to the gyno, that is 100% my fault. I was freaking terrified. I'm not saying it's the doctor's fault. No, I'm not. I'm just sharing my story and what happened. And that's what happened. Yes, of course I heard about Dana. She's one of my really good friends. Vlogmas. I've thought about Vlogmas. I always start thinking about Vlogmas around summertime. I know it's not summer yet, but it's fixin' be. I don't think I'm gonna do Vlogmas this year. Yes, I would visit North Korea. Yeah, I love me a Vlogmas moment, but I don't know. I need to put mental health first, always. No, this isn't like a live era. I think just for right now, because I just feel like I can't peacefully make vlogs or like YouTube videos, knowing that there's just so many things that people are getting wrong. Oh my God, it's moving so fast and I have it on slow mode. Is there a way I can make it even slower? Are you really truly think you are being honest with your therapist? Yes. And I'm very, very honest in my therapy. I'm here to take advantage. I pay over $200 per session, so I'm not going to sit here and not take advantage of it. You never once said anything bad about Destiny's mom, even though she disrespected you majorly. That shows how compassionate and understanding you are. Thank you, James. That's because I really, really love her mom. Through it all. When people assumed that I hit Destiny's mom, which I didn't. So thank you, Destiny, for clarifying that. Thank you for being honest. Then when Destiny came back to clarify, Amberlynn didn't hit my mom. My mom beat up Amberlynn. All the same people are now, oh, Amberlynn deserved it. For anyone to like validate abuse, yikes on bikes. Her last live stream that she did, right after I did one, obsessed much, she did clarify that I have not lied about anything regarding her mom. So thanks, Destiny, again. Destiny is a known cheater and liar, and people are just choosing to believe her because it's more fun. It's more entertainment. And the reason why I continue to stand up for myself and share my story is because it's empowering. I am so tired of people putting words in my mouth. I would rather use my mouth to use the right words, if that makes sense. Like, if this was just about money, this would have already happened. I'm only on here because Destiny started this. So if this was about money, or I wanted to manipulate the audience, or whatever it may be, or I wanted drama on my channel, this would have already happened.
Give me money. Money me. Money now. Me a money needing a lot now.
So it's like, the fact that this is also my job, having to defend myself, it's rough. Stop dodging questions. I'm not really getting any. Did I sit on one of my exes? What? I sit on Feline.
Oh, geez Louise.
No, I swear to God, I sit on her and she likes it. I'm not even lying. I hate it. Like, I don't hate it. I hated it in the beginning because I am a self-conscious bitch.
Nope.
But y'all, there are people out there who do not give a fuck if you're fat. They don't give a fuck. They see beyond that. And she's one of them. And I'm very fucking grateful. Can I introduce you to the caterpillars? I'm said, stop. Yes, I can. It's Mary Kate and Ashley. Nice to meet you. Do I have an OF? No, I do not. Yes, I do have a Telfar bag, which is also from Feline. Wow, I sound spoiled. A little spoiled. How would I spend $1 million? I would give a lot of it away, I feel like. Like, my first thought was giving it to people who need it. I've already made $1 million in my lifetime. I know it don't look like it.
I want my money, bitch.
It's so funny when people say ALR doing live streams because she wants money. So annoying. That's like someone going to work, like going to be a waitress, or someone writing a book, or someone, whatever they may do, starting OnlyFans. It's because people need money to survive. Things that should be free, like a roof over your head and water and food, are not free things. So yes, this is my job. Getting heat for making money, well, it's so weird. I don't know. I can't process it. Like, would I collab with Nick Accato? No, I would not. He makes a mockery out of domestic abuse, like, and gets away with it. It's disgusting. And he's also the one who said I lied about cancer. Disgusting.
Everyone trolls on the internet, you know? Everyone trolls.
Yeah, it's fun, isn't it?
It's very fun. It's so fun to troll. So what if I, you know, said something that might be trolling, but no one would dare to question if it's a troll? Something. Maybe something hypothetical, maybe possibility.
Like something taboo?
Something taboo, you know, a subject you never want to talk about. Or question the validity of.
Because might be offensive.
What president would you want to meet? Obama.
Thank you. Stay woke, bitches.
Can I bring back my intro music? Maybe. I just feel like no one liked it. Some people only have to write one book. It goes famous and they're done for the rest of their life. Not to bring up reaction channels, but Zachary Michael's a really good example. Like, he went to college for what he was doing for his career. And he ended up quitting his career to react to me.
And talk about
weird. I feel like that's weird. I don't know. Like,
end the video.
That's just an opinion.
Goodbye.
Like, going to college, like, you're literally actively in a career and then you quit to react to Amberlynn Reid, a very boring YouTuber. Like, that's weird. It's just more of like the hypocrisy. Ma'am, it's just people being hypocrites. And it's like, a lot of people agree that it's weird. Thank you. I film my life. I talk about my true innards. Yeah, take that as a quote, please. Like my last vlog or my last live stream, people love the quote. I said she left me like a raisin. Because it's true, she did. She left me like a raisin. Oh, definitely not jealous. He only gets views because of me. Like, it's so weird that, like, that's my life, that people want to see it. That's something that people want to see so bad that they also watch it through other people. They, like, watch people watch me. And this won't be, this might be one of my narcissistic tendencies. Because I didn't get the attention and a love that a child should get, that I'm probably trying to get that from strangers online, which, you know what, might be right, might be true. Something that I recently discovered that I've been going through, which is really weird and happened in the middle of therapy today, is like, I dissociate. I don't really know much about it, but I know the fucking feeling, and that shit is scary. It happened a couple times during my last live stream that I did. So yeah, it's just like random little things that I'm dealing with, and now I'm rambling and someone just told me to shut up. But yeah, there is a midline shift in your face. Your front tooth is directly in the center of your face. It's because I used to have a massive gap, huge gap for years, and my teeth have shifted, and it made that happen. Yes, I know. Girl, we all have a sad story. Stop acting like a victim. I am a victim to some things. I've learned that people are very unsympathetic to certain situations, and it's so easy for people to say stop being a victim when they just don't give a shit about you. I also want to say I have done some research about what I said regarding I prefer females. That's not what I meant to say, because I've learned that female is the sex while being a woman is the gender. No, I really truly did not know the difference. And then I was getting so many messages and stuff, and I was just like, oh my God, how was I that stupid and that ignorant? No, I have not done Delta 8 in over a month. I miss it a lot. Yes, Feline lives with me. It's both of us together.
Forever.
Are you proposing? My favorite thing about Feline. Yeah, oh my God, so many.
Go ahead, tell me.
You're hardworking as shit. Supportive. Like, if I ever say, like, oh, I want to write a guided journal, like, you're the one who's over there like, let me do the research, I can figure it out for you, like, you got this, babe. Like, you're just so supportive. No, don't be tearing up. We'll save the mushy gushy for later. I love you. That's not true. Oh, I can twerk. Crying for no reason. Oh my God, have you never been in love? Like, true, like, when I think of Feline and the things that I like about her, and the things that I love about her, like, and the person that she is, it makes, like, I feel it, like, in my heart. Crying because I love somebody, or I'm crying because I'm happy, or I'm crying because something bad happened. Everyone always says crocodile tears. I think that is, like, one of the most triggering things that people say to me. It's very triggering when people say that to me. It is. When people say that, it makes me feel like I'm being invalidated. They want to know what your favorite thing about me is.
I think it has to be just how loving you are. Like, you have such a big heart.
Thank you.
And, like, even when people do you wrong, you're just so willing to forgive.
Did you guys hear her? She said that it's how loving, that I have a big heart, and that no matter how, like in the past, like, what people do to me, I have room in my heart to forgive people. There we go. I didn't know how to word it. Someone just said Delta 8 is a gateway drug to meth. No. That makeup's been on for days. This is fresh makeup from today. Wait. Notice in my last live stream, because I had the blinds open, I decided not to have them open this time, that my eyeliner looks so uneven. And I'm like, girl, it's not. Like, my eyeliner stays even. It was just like a literal elliptical. What? What's the illusion word? Elliptical?
Illusion?
No, elliptical. Wait, optical! Oh my God, I thought I was on it. That was scary. Optical! My therapist says that when this happens, to put myself back into myself. Come to your lover bones. Knocked me out. I'm good. Yeah, my IQ is just, it's just overwhelmed by how smart I am. Work that camo. Hey, I'm not wearing a bra. Is that okay? Would it tickle to rip your nose ring out? To rip it out? That wouldn't tickle. That would hurt. Okay, so someone just said, why did you stink so bad with Destiny? So Destiny said that it was after we were together. One of my symptoms of cancer was so people like making fun of me about that, you're literally just making fun of someone that had cancer in one of their symptoms. So yikes on bikes, that's on you. That's actually something I talked to Eric and Ricky about, is because obviously everyone around me noticed. It's not something that was unnoticed, obviously. And again, that is something else that was noticed and talked about. So I start a poll. Ooh, should we do a poll? Crap. Did I just make my first poll ever?
Congrats, baby.
Thanks, babes. I did it. Yay. Which do you prefer? Live streams or vlogs? Dang, so many votes. I'm popular. That was fun. How's Feline doing?
I'm doing good.
She's watching some earwax videos. She's watching earwax videos. Do you eat potatoes still? I do. What is swamp A's? I have no idea what that is. And people were wondering, how did you get diagnosed with cancer? So,
and I know what it means when I am told repeatedly, when I just want to forget, that I have precancerous cells. I'm not an idiot. I'm not a fucking idiot.
I was bleeding for over 2 years. And then there were some times where I would bleed so much, the whole, like half of the toilet would get filled. And one night in particular scared the fuck out of me. And I looked at my girlfriend at the time and I said, I need to go to the ER. And I ended up bleeding all over the hospital floor. It was just falling out of me. I had uterine lining and blood clots completely just falling out of me. So I got sent into an emergency DNC. They took some uterine lining, the tissue, and they biopsied it. Yesterday was actually 3-year anniversary of me getting diagnosed with cancer.
You know, sometimes I forget that I have cancer.
And they said, you have cancer. And thankfully, I had endometrial cancer, which it was stage 1B, grade 2. Is it because you weighed so much? That is initially how it started. My whole life, even in high school, I would have the craziest periods. I wouldn't have periods for like 6 months, and all of a sudden I'd have a period for a full month. So eventually that lining ended up getting cancer, and the cancer was then moving into the muscle of my uterus. Yeah, it's fucked up, and it is because of my weight. But it's like every day now, I just feel scared that I'm gonna die because of my weight. Because it's like, I know I'm gonna die because of my weight.
Because your weight, whether you are too small or too big, can mess with someone's hormones, which then messes with someone's period.
Children, I do, but I'm not ready, and I don't know if I ever will be.
Okay, Wendy and Baby Vlog asked, oh, Destiny is so cute with her baby fever. I don't know if you guys mentioned it before, but how do you guys plan to have a baby? Destiny ain't the only one with baby fever. It's me too, like to the extreme. Okay.
I mean, realistically, no one is ever ready for a child, ever. But there is like a time, and there is a line that you cross where it's like, okay, I can have a kid. And I don't think I'll ever cross that line. Where's Twinkie right there? That's my kid right there. One of three. And I try to be the best for mama that I can. Do I ever plan on running? No. Play with my fupa or something. Okay, I'll do that. And I wear my heart on my sleeve. I'm a very, very emotional person. Got it from my mom. What'd you get your body from? Got it from my mom. Damn. I got it from my mama. I got it. She is the same way. Mama. I already apologized to Narc Alert. Yes, I am running for president 2024. I wasn't going to tell anybody. Damn, this message was approved by Amberlynn Reid. Fuck. My voice is boring? I've never heard anyone say that. Like, they think you're boring, but they stay. I mean, true. I have like 2,000 people watching right now. Hi. That's 4,000 eyeballs. Chantel made fun of your choking and poo incident. Who hasn't? Who fucking hasn't? Like, if Feline wasn't there, I would have died. I would have died. And to like come on here and like have a mukbang of potatoes, like you are a horrible person, period. Like, how am I celebrating Pride Month? Eating a lot of pussy.
I should probably get off. Do I like horror movies? What's your fave? I do. I enjoyed Smile. That was a good one. That creeped me out for some reason. Like that smile. Wait, how do they smile? I want to do it. Use that as a thumbnail. Evil Dead had no plot, but it was scary. It was scary. Like, it was like, what is happening? I just wish there was more of a plot. Yeah. Someone just said that's how Chantel smiles. Dear Heavenly Father. Get the hell out. You have a good shoe collection.
Look at his baby shoe collection.
Mm-mm. Wait. But his feet are fixing to be big.
Baby, you got a whole ass locker.
Oh, hell. Oh, someone called me a goddess. Oh, I'm blushing. Stop. Someone said goddess of poop. Okay. Well, there it is. I will see you guys in the next one. All right. I'm going to go make out.
You say I make you nervous, a tragedy, I'm a beautiful disaster, a reckoning, you wonder how I got this way. You think I'm someone to be saved, someone to clean up and tame, oh, some things never change, never change, oh.